Hello YouTube, this is Lilitha Star, and welcome back to Lilitha. So, we're building in Red Rocket after so many weeks of not building at all. And I've already taken the liberty of clearing it out and building a nice big wall around the perimeter. So this is the biggest that this settlement can be with the walls. So, here we go. She's already got some nice wheat growing. I'm pretty sure that's pretty much all I've done. I do have a provisioner, which is now stuck in the apartment, apparently. And everything all in here is all ready to go. So we got some suits and everything. So, the idea this time round is to show you roughly how you go about creating a kind of like multi-story. Oh wait, I forgot I'm in the special one. So yeah, how you go about creating a nice, let's say, restaurant area for you to restaurant and bar area that you can also use as a I'm having one of those days. A hotel. So, I'm gonna pull it out and make it. Yeah, that's about the right size. Smaller than the one in the sanctuary. We don't want it to be particularly huge. So the first thing you're going to want to remember to do is that you need one of these at some points on the floor. Otherwise, it really doesn't work. Now, I built the one of these that I had in Sanctuary when I didn't have any mods. So, Liara's going insane in the background. Right, you build these with the shack upper floors. Kind of fits better than using the normal floors. You're gonna be like that, aren't you? We knew this was gonna happen. So instead, we're just gonna. Sorry, handcart. You're going to lose these floors in a moment. Oh wait, no, it's not. Actually, I think. Right, so. What did I mean by showing you? Right, so the only way to put walls, doorways in to create rooms is to use a prefab section. Has the door in it. Where are you? It's going to be one of those days where I can't find anything. I really can't find anything. I was sure it was a prefab. With a door in it. There we go, that's what you need. So, there's a reason I was going to make it as big as I did, that's why. So, oops. Yeah, you want to put that like that. Because otherwise, there is no normal way for you to install doorways into your home unless you use mods. So this actually would work if you don't have any mods. In fact, I'm probably not going to use any mods now to build this. I'm just going to show you how roughly to flesh out one area. Okay, so say you want to build a couple of rooms, basically. Okay, so you want these prefabs and that two doors into rooms. Sort that out, but not right now. Okay, and then depending on what you want the walls to be, the single walls, you're going to want to, now you don't want to use any of the ones that have arches on the inner doorways. You really don't, it doesn't work. You want to build these doorways in these first, okay? Otherwise it the roof won't work, you won't be able to get anything else in, it won't work, okay? So you want to build these first. Oh, and make sure they're straight. Yes. And align with the floor. Yep. Okay, and then use your chosen thingy of choice. Now, I like using the door frames. Where are they? These things. I like using these. Now, you're going to see why in a minute. On the outside of the building. Wow, it helps if I go straight, doesn't it? I can't go straight. Make it so it fits for you, basically, because I'm apparently going to be here forever because I suck at this. So, why have I done this? Now, I like to give everybody a window in their little bedroom, but also, actually, I better put that one there because it makes more sense because there's the red rockets going to be right there. I could build another one right there. In fact, I'm going to. There is a reason, and it will become apparent. So anyway, to make some windows, you have your door, obviously, and then you put your little panel right there, and you have a window that looks out, and then you can see, so kind of a bit more security conscious as well. Okay, why is there a tree there? Because there was a tree. Okay. And then you just, like I said, choose some different ones. Don't ever choose all the same ones. It gets very boring very quickly. But basically now, you can see where enemies are coming from. Maybe not on that window because there's a wall right there. But you can kind of see where some enemies are coming from when you are... your settlers are trying to defend themselves, which is quite nice. So as I said, you don't need any mods for this set, you can do it without mods, because I've just done it without mods. And then you can add as many walls in as you want, really simply. You can add as many levels as you want, just don't forget to obviously make your stairs make sure your stairs fit. So for example, stop that and we will create a floor with the stair. Okay. Okay, sometimes I don't want to go in. And then you can just walk all the way up. The reason you don't want to use the shack floors is because then you can do this over the top of the floors if you don't want to have another set. You can do that. If you don't want to have another set of like doors or buildings, you can build that bit in and then you have a complete, you know, covered area. Oh, I didn't mean to destroy that. So yeah, that's roughly how I went about building the inn area in the sanctuary. This bit I'm probably going to do a walkway to get across to the roof so we can try and do some stuff on the roof. But that is a very quick idea of how to build yourself. So the bottom floor would be like where your bar and your drinks and your people can club or dance or do whatever they want to do. I might actually build a little bit under here, a garden kind of thing for people to come out and drink. And then this here is how you build a doorway. A room in without like mods that allow you to place doors anywhere and stuff like that. So that's the basics of the Red Rocket Inn. Well, obviously it looks a bit crap now because we have no walls, so obviously just as an example, let's build some walls very quickly. So I know a lot of people say you don't want to do boxy, but I quite like boxy. In fact, actually, if you don't want to do boxy, right there. I did a lot of this in Sanctuary, like creating extra entryways and stuff. Two places so that it looked kind of different to the others. And I'm hoping that it shows. You are going to be a pain, aren't you? Of course you're going to be a pain. Sticks that in. Oh, I forgot this. You're going to be right plane on you. We need to do that and then go to your doors. Which, like I said, we'll just leave that door there but for the simple reason of we can turn that into a window or something nice like that. And then, the only problem is it does kind of leave a little bit of a gap between walls sometimes, but it's that quite easily. By going right. So anywhere that you don't need metal shack floor piece, you can then. You should probably do this first, actually. Yeah. Nope. So, yeah, anywhere that you don't have the little metal floory bits. Where there are, you can, I think, gonna need a flat roof. That one actually can go just there. Because I like this one a lot. Oh god. Nice. Yeah, so you do that. And that creates your slightly more even floor. Wow, there's my. There it is. And there you go, you can't see damn anything. Come on, behave. Just did it. That. There we go. So that's how you make it. I'm gonna sort this bit out in a second. So figure out. That's what's causing it. Right. I'll just do that for a moment. Okay. Right, so if you have something like that happen, go back to your shack flooring and then. Whoops. Come on. And then put it down. Of course, this game is glitchy as all hell. Okay, so that is roughly how you go about doing it. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I will see you next time when I figure out something to build for you. And take care, and I hope you like and subscribe, have fun, enjoy yourselves, and show me some of the stuff that you've made too. So take care, and goodbye.